اسمي يارا رفعت سلام، بشتغل باحثة في منظمة حقوق الإنسان المصرية. اللي خلاني اهتم بحقوق الإنسان يمكن من وانا عندي 15 سنة كنت متطوعة في منظمة بشتغل على حقوق الطفل اسمها النسور الصغيرة، ومن ساعتها وانا حسيت ان الموضوع يعني هممني. بعدها دخلت كلية حقوق، وفي الوسط يعني كل الأنشطة الطلابية اللي قدرت أدخلها ليها علاقة بحقوق الإنسان أو نشاط طلابي، كنت بعمل شغلي في حقوق الإنسان قبل ما الثورة تبدأ، كان دايما محاط كده بحالة من إنه مفيش حاجة هتتغير، وإنه عمر يعني مبارك هيفضل قاعد وهيجي بعديه جمال مبارك، مفيش أي حاجة خالص هتغير، إحنا بس بنشتغل كده لله وللوطن يعني، والحاجات ليها علاقة بالتوثيق وكده، وإيماني يعني بالبحث عامة.
هو وقت انا كنت اقعد ناكف في يارا واقول لها يارا انت محاميه، بتقولي لا انا مدافعه عن حقوق الانسان، في فرق، انا حقوقيه. ما اعرفش اذا كان يعني انا كانت فكرتي عن المحامين او الكليات اللي بتخرجوا منها ان ناس كتير ويعني بياخد يعني اعداد كتيره نتيجه المجموع الضعيف وكده هو، لكن تاريخيا الناس الحقوقيين في مصر كان ناس كبار ومهمين ومثقفين على عكس الفترة بتاعتنا يعني. فالفرق بين حقوقي وقانوني يعني شوية حديث نسبيا، والفكرة ان ممكن انت تبقى يعني حقوقي ومش شرط خارج حقوق، يعني في ناس كتيرة من الأجيال القديمة شوية مش خارجين حقوق لكنهم حقوقيين، لأن الحقوق ممكن تتخذ بالمعنى الإنساني، وهو ده المدخل الأساسي بالنسبة ليارا اللي بتأكد عليه بكذا طريقة يعني.
She was very approachable and also funny, and I thought that was, you know, as I got to know the human rights community, I appreciated that even more, because finding a human rights defender who's not kind of bitter was the norm. So a funny activist was always great. I remember that she mentioned once in her blog, which was called Passion Out of All Things, that if this movement doesn't bring her happiness and happiness to everyone else around her, then she really doesn't see the point. And that she always has in mind that she doesn't want to be an old bitter activist, but to, yeah. And there was a quote that she shared on that blog that I really loved, and I thought, you know, it would be great if I can share it. And it's that my life, if it can have any meaning at all, or if it will ever be remembered, I want it to be about hope, laughter, joy, passion, and love for life. And my revolution is the same.
Yara's a very unique person as a colleague and as a friend. I know we tend to talk in a very passionate way about our colleagues and friends that are going through difficult times, but I genuinely think that she's a very unique person. Unique in the sense that she shows a level of compassion, solidarity, and support that very few people do. And she's also very passionate about life. She always has plans and ideas and new things to do.
She led the Women Human Rights Defenders program at NELSRA for Feminist Studies for almost 2 years. She started the program, and it was, we kind of started off with her vision that in order to really start using the term Women Human Rights Defenders meaningfully in Egypt, and it was rarely if ever used before the program started introducing it, it's that we have to produce research, which was non-existent, and then use evidence-based advocacy in forms such as the African Commission for Human People's Rights and the Human Rights Council.
As a colleague, Yara is a very solid researcher. She's one of the people that would try her best to actually get to the bottom of things. She would go through the documentation she has over and over again. She'd go through the legal analysis over and over again.
She had a clear understanding of the uses of international mechanisms and advocacy tools that not a lot of people have even now. And I think that comes also from her work with the African Commission. So she would say, you know, this was a space where feminist voices are really non-existent, and the term woman human rights defender is not even, it's not really ingrained in the system around how the commission works, and that language, that we need more people to use that, to introduce that language in those spaces where the voices of women human rights defenders, of feminist voices, are not very common.
شايفة هي اتقبض عليها عشوائيًا زي وبيتقبض واتقبض عليها بواسطة مخبرين مش لابسين زي الرسمي بتاع الشرطة يعني واتقبض عليها مع ابن خالتها يعني فهم كانوا يعني قبضوا عليهم بعدين سابوهم بعدين قرروا ياخدوا ابن خالتها يعني فهي بتقول لهم ليه بتاخدوه فقالوا لها مش عاجبك تعالي معانا فحتى أنا بشوف في جزئية الحادثة دي الفعل التلقائي بتاع يارا حتى كإنسانة بتدافع عن الآخرين يعني وهم في التحقيق في الاسم بعد فترة بعد شوية تحقيقات يعني سابوا ابن خالتها واحتفظوا بيها لما عرفوا بتشتغل في المبادرة المصرية للحقوق الشخصية.
We believe that Yara was targeted particularly because she works for EIPR. Even though hundreds and thousands of people are been arrested in 2013 and 2014 for demonstrating, we do genuinely believe that she was targeted, particularly because she's a human rights defender. Yara's arrest had a very negative impact on EIPR, the staff, on myself, her friends, and on the movement at large, particularly because we could see that the person that made the decision to keep her in the case made that decision based on the fact that she works for a human rights organization. The summer of 2013 and 2014 were very difficult years for human rights defenders and people that went out and documented the atrocities that took place at the time. And I think one of our main defense mechanisms was to try as much as possible to keep the human rights violations as far away from us on the personal level as possible, make them, try hard to make them impersonal. And I think when Yara was arrested, at least for me as a person, it wasn't just the impact of Yara's arrest herself, but it was actually the fact that it brought back all those memories of the hundreds of people that were killed on the streets, and we had to document and report on them, and the thousands that were arrested. So it had, in a way, Yara's arrest had that dual impact on most of us, in a way that made our work afterwards even more painful and more difficult.
This award would definitely galvanize the Egyptian home base and also reignite this attention around the injustice that the protest law has brought to so many people. And I think this is really would be very important for Yara, is that we don't just talk about her case, but to also say that there are a lot of people just beyond even those who were arrested with her in the same Hadiya demonstration, who are also very negatively affected from this law. She was always very aware that people get attention because of all of their privileges. And she would say that, you know, yes, this is happening to me, but it's also very important to say that thousands are also affected. And I think the award would be a reminder of that, because at the moment we're living in this very nationalist-y hype where talking about women human rights defenders or talking about the protest law is not very welcomed. So having a great occasion like winning this award would kind of remind people that someone like Kiara, who has made a lot of really important contributions, in my opinion, is in prison for, you know, buying a water bottle from a kiosk in the context of a demonstration.
Help protect human rights defenders on the front line. Contribute at www.frontlinedefenders.org/donate. Thank you.